All right, so first things first, if you enjoy these types of videos, please give us a like and a comment. We'd love to be able to get your feedback on this. And obviously, you get to enjoy watching Baloo and his facial expressions as we give him a bath. With that, it really goes a long ways for a small account like ours, for everything that, you know, you comment, watch the full video, give us a like. So we really appreciate it. And thank you for your support. So first off, kind of in our first process with Baloo and giving a bath, we always try to go actually to a do-it-yourself for a couple of reasons. One, obviously, as you can see, he's a big dog. And so trying to fit him into a bathtub or, you know, fit him, you know, outside even with a hose. It's in the middle of winter here in Idaho. Not exactly something that I want to be outside doing. Getting wet and trying to, you know, groom my dog. So it's always nice to be able to go somewhere in this location, the dog wash that we have close by us. So the Meridian does a great job, a really clean facility. So I always really enjoy, you know, going over there. So, you know, Baloo here, we typically start down with a rinse. You can see he's super calm, you know, no real big whining or barking or anything like that, so it really enjoys it. But the rinse usually takes a good, you know, 6 to 10 minutes. I cut a lot of different footage out of this to make sure that we try to get this done in a reasonable amount of time on a video, as well as obviously, as you can see, it's sped up. So he doesn't obviously like his butt getting wet, but you know, there's a lot of dirt and grime and everything else that gets in there. So for him, this was his first bath coming back from the vet, so we wanted to really kind of get a deep clean. And so spending that extra time just trying to get him wet with that double coat can really take a lot of time. So as you can see again, right, really doesn't like getting his butt, you know, washed. So luckily we've taught a couple of different commands with the stand, and that he understands that he needs to be standing up. But even with that, right, still giving me a hard time trying to be able to get everything. So usually the entire process kind of looks like this. We typically do a full rinse down. We do, you know, shampoo. Then we're gonna do another rinse, get all of that out of them. Then we're gonna do the conditioner, another rinse. Then we're gonna kind of try to squeegee him, which is an idea which you're gonna see here soon. And then towel dry from there, and then the air dryer. So shampoo, they've got a great mixture, so we just kind of use what they give to us. And this little blue tool, really kind of gets in there deep and allows kind of some of that grime that's built up against their skin, as well as kind of helps de-shed a little bit of that extra fur that's kind of matted down and everything throughout time. So we try to get that, you know, definitely kind of built into his undercoat and the hind quarters underneath his, you know, chest and kind of on his belly as well. Good yawn. So he's definitely a lot more calm when you compare him to, like, say Bianca. Bianca's not a big bath time fan, and so we'll get some video up of her at a later date, you know, taking a bath, especially if you don't have Baloo near her when she's trying to take a bath. It is not her favorite activity whatsoever. Thank you. So again, really just fighting me and trying to get to his butt. Again, really doesn't like it, but just trying to get all of that grime and everything taken off. So last kind of point of emphasis, as you'll kind of notice here, is Baloo is really prone to hot spots, and so one reason we really like to also go to a location that has a professional dryer, because in the past, you know, if you just get wet or you stick his face in the water bowl or do some, you know, very Newfie like for that, we didn't get him dry enough, then you get a hot spot. And so one of the reasons I think that he sits so well for a bath is, as a, you know, young puppy getting into stuff, he probably got, you know, 3 or 4 baths in that first couple of week time frame and had to get used to the hair dryer because he, you know, just simply would just get hot spots. So I think he had one under his chin when he was a little guy, just because, again, he'd stick his head in the water bowl and just fall asleep like that. And we didn't notice how, you know, wet he was staying until, you know, it's kind of too late. He also kind of got one onto his chest that he had spilt the water bowl and then, you know, went and laid in it. So, you know, he's definitely found different ways to kind of get wet and stay wet. So drying has been a big point of emphasis for us. So here you can really kind of see, like, I'm trying to get that squeegee. So, you know, obviously no professional groomer here, but, you know, one of the things that was recommended to us by one of the groomers was someone with, like, a double coat like Baloo, is really try to just kind of push that water. And you can really feel it when you're pushing that water out of their coat. And then that way you'll kind of save yourself from towels, or as many towels. And we already go through, you know, like I think I said 5 towels on the video, but, you know, it wouldn't shock me if we went through more, especially kind of these smaller towels. The heavier bath towels will probably still go through 2 or 3, just trying to get him dry. So he's just got a lot of fur. And then the drying process, obviously from towel dry to completely dry, even with these commercial grade, you know, dryers, you're looking at, you know, anywhere from, you know, 20 minutes as I put in there to, you know, 30-40 minutes. And so, you know, I love these things. You can obviously see how much water just gets sprayed off when, you know, you're just whipping it back and forth. And you can see how calm he is just because of all the years of, or, well, not even year, but months of just, you know, hitting it with a hair dryer. So still get a little puppy out of him every once in a while when he tries to bite it. Thanks for watching. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video, and hopefully we'll see you back here soon.